Hi, my name is Tyrone Shum from Internet Business Path, and welcome to a guided tour of the ActiveCollab. What I'd like to do is just give you a quick rundown of what this particular project management software is, and also give you a little sneak preview of what's inside. I mean, you can actually hop onto the ActiveCollab and see a demo of it on their website, but I thought I'd show you interaction of how it works on my blog. This is a project management software that I currently use for my own business to manage all the projects that I currently have. And it's a fantastic little software. Reason why I chose this is because it allows you to customize and to create things within it. Also, you can even put an unlimited amount of projects and unlimited amount of users. And that's the reason why I like about this one. So you're not limited by using someone else's server to have this software running. And also you're not limited by how many you can actually have. So let's get straight into it, and I'll log into this particular, let me just log straight in. Here we go. Okay, so logging right in. As you can see, this is the dashboard or the control panel, and you can actually see that the different things are here. The first thing you probably notice is that it gives you just recent activities, active projects, and also what is due for today. And that's just really what happens is when you log into it. You can customize this to different colors. You can skin this to whatever you're liking. I've just kept it simple because that's what my guys and myself actually do. So we want to be able to just communicate. Firstly, I'll explain all these different things here. You've got the people, which are the people who you can actually put into this software. Can be your clients, can be your programmers, your VAs, anyone that is going to be using this software. A list of your projects, a calendar. This is just like a calendar to allow you to see which dates and also projects are due on this following date. An assignment. Now, this particular thing is when you click on it, it shows you what tasks have been assigned to you. So if you logged in as one of your programmers, you click on that and you'll see all the updates of assignments that you need to do. I wouldn't worry too much about these at the moment, but the most important thing I wanted to show you is projects, just to give you a brief rundown why it's so good and so powerful to use this particular software. I also find that by using this particular software, it gives you a lot of flexibility because it allows you to keep everything all at one hand. I used to use emails back and forth with programmers and VAs, and it just got really messy. So after coming across this, you can actually manage everything within each project. This is usually your projects list and tells you all of the projects that are currently running. And I just wanted to show you one of them so that you could get a clear understanding of what this project management software allows you to do. So as you can probably see, you've got just a brief overview of what is happening with this software. Even tells you a little task completion bar, which is fantastic because it tells you whether or not it's on track and you're getting everything completed. What I find that has been very important is your milestones, checklists, discussions, files, and pages. Those are the things I mainly use. You can use all the other functionalities if you want. It usually comes within the software when you purchase it as a full license. But the good thing is about milestones, it allows you to actually set dates and also tasks that need to be completed by certain times, and it can be scheduled and tells you exactly when things are due. The most important thing here is that you want your people who are working for you to actually complete these within a certain time, and that's the reason why it's crucial to have these. Checklists is your tasks. Discussions. Now, as I said, I was emailing back and forth. With discussions, it allows you to communicate with each other what's going on, and instead of having emails, you've actually got a whole list of topics that are in here that you need to talk about and complete. Files allows you to actually upload any images or any Word documents, anything that's related to the project. And finally, pages. I usually use pages just to store login information and also any other vital information that goes towards the website to give the programmers or VAs or anyone managing this particular website access. So that is just a basic quick overview, and I hope that you'd be able to use this project management software called ActiveCollab. If you want more information, just continue to read my blog and I'll give you the link as well to it. I'm Tyrone Shum, and I hope you enjoyed this ActiveCollab review.